It's an honor for me to stand here today in solidarity with the men and women of the Pennsylvania State Corrections Officers Association. And Larry, I was proud to introduce that bill. Mr. Williams, God bless you, and it is, I am extremely proud today to be able to meet you. And to get that bill signed into law so that our corrections officers have a tool to maintain control inside the walls and protect themselves. But the reality is, I should not have had to do that. The Department of Corrections could have implemented pepper spray themselves, but they didn't. And here we are, nearly 4 years later, still fighting for better protection for the officers in our prisons. I've walked through SCI Green. I've walked through SCI Fayette. I know what our corrections officers face every day. And still, the Department of Corrections is making their jobs, these folks standing right here with us today, harder and even more dangerous. Just a few weeks ago, you heard Larry refer earlier at SCI Green, which I represent, right in my backyard. An officer was stabbed 35 times. He struggled and fought for his life until help finally arrived. By the grace of God, he survived. Will the next officer be so lucky? We're here today because we don't want a next officer. We don't want another assault that leaves our COs fighting for their lives, or worse, dead. We don't want another assault that leaves a family like Lynn Basserman without a husband and a father. The Department of Corrections has introduced policies that empower the inmates, not the officers. When we talk about prison reform, it does not mean we should be turning criminals loose too early. It does not mean the Department of Corrections should cover up the actions of inmates inside the walls so they can be paroled and make the numbers look good. The Department of Corrections should be reporting incidents that occur inside truthfully and accurately, but that is not what is happening. That's why I introduced House Bill 44 that would allow corrections officers to testify at an inmate's parole hearing. I'm pleased to say that it passed the House unanimously, and I would ask my colleagues in the Senate to make sure it comes up for a vote as soon as possible. If inmates know that corrections officers can testify at their parole hearings, there's no doubt their actions could change. We can reduce recidivism and maybe stop a parolee from killing someone on the outside yet again. I call on the Department of Corrections to take a serious look at how the programs they continue to implement have had a negative impact on their employees and have reduced safety and security in the prison system. We, the General Assembly, have an obligation to our state corrections officers to ensure that they don't have to fear for their life every day they show up for work as employees of this Commonwealth. Every day they show up to protect us. Every day they show up to do their job. I'm honored to stand with each and every one of you here today, and I vow to have your backs, the backs at SCI Green, the backs at SCI Fayette, and every other institution in this Commonwealth.